Welcome to Physics for Good. I'm Allison Bowley, and today I want to talk about the Doppler effect. Now, the Doppler effect is something that you hear a lot in traffic, but you may not have known what was causing it. And now we're going to learn. Now, we know from experience that when you create a ripple, that wave spreads out symmetrically. But what happens when you move the dropper? Well, each individual wave still spreads out symmetrically, but because the dropper is moving, it looks like the waves have bunched up in front, and it looks like the waves have spread out behind. Let's watch again with that in mind. And that is the Doppler effect. Now, I suggest if you want to try this at home, one time try holding the dropper still and instead move the pan of water. If you can do it without sloshing, you'll see the Doppler effect occur there too. And that's because there only has to be relative motion between the two. And this is the same thing that you've probably experienced in traffic. So if we have an ambulance or a fire truck or anything that's moving while it's honking its horn, then we know that sound is a wave. And so as long as the source of the sound is moving, those wavelengths are going to appear to bunch up in front of it, and they're going to appear to spread out behind it. And so we know that in a sound wave, small wavelengths correspond to high pitch. So as that ambulance is coming towards you, you hear a high pitch. And then as it passes you by, we know a long wavelength corresponds to low pitch. And so the pitch of the sound, as the source of the sound passes you by, gets lower. Here's what that sounds like in real life. Did you hear the change in pitch? If not, let's listen again. Which brings me to East Valley Firefighter Charities. In addition to helping me out with the Doppler effect demo, they invited me to a station to talk with Executive Director Steve Heyer.
We represent firefighters, over 800 firefighters from the East Valley, from Mesa, Gilbert, Queen Creek, Superstition Fire, Florence, Fort McDowell, Gila River, and Salt River Fire Departments. We have a very unique opportunity with people that we meet during our job, during 911 calls and out in the public, to find people in the community that need help. Mm-hmm. We give back to the community that way, and we also help organizations locally, many of the other charities locally and nationally. Each year we do a variety of things. We have some fundraisers, a golf tournament, a charity ride we do every year, different fundraisers. And then what we do is we use that money for adopt-a-family programs. Around Thanksgiving, we adopt about 30 to 40 families where we give them meals where they wouldn't be able to have a meal. And then Christmas, we adopt between 150 and 200 families every year to give kids toys where families are down on their luck.
That's awesome.
And then we help people that are burned out of their homes or having medical issues in their house. Maybe a family member has cancer or issues like that.
Right. And that's why I really wanted this episode to be about them. When I first saw East Valley Firefighter Charities, I assumed it was to help out firefighters, and that would be a fantastic thing. But that's not what these guys do. They go into homes, and they see the opportunity to help others, and they do it. But to further illustrate the firefighter life, Steve helped me get into about 30 pounds of gear. And he says once they are carrying their packs and a tool, it's more like 65 to 70 pounds. They take about 30 to 60 seconds to get into their gear. I took, well, longer.
So first thing you do is you put the hood on.
Okay.
Okay, just slip that over your head, pull it down, right like that. And then you slip your feet in, probably going to be a little bit big. Okay, then grab both sides. Make sure you can slip them up. There you go. Pull up, and then you have your suspenders. And then you have a couple snaps. Right there. And you can click this. And that's just your bumper pants are on.
Okay.
And you got the jacket, and you'll feel how heavy.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. So we've got a bunch of claps, and then we'll just kind of do this, and your thumb will go through the little hole. You got your whole hand through the thumb hole.
Oh. Oh, I see.
See? So that way, when you're in a fire, this can't go up.
Oh, right.
Over your hands. The biggest thing is to make sure your skin is covered the whole time.
Okay.
Then you have Your helmet.
Thanks.
Okay. And the last thing is your gloves. And everything is heavy because you want to have protection over, you know, from the heat and the smoke, and that's why we have our SCBA bottles also. Cool. So you can feel how it,
yeah,
it stays pretty well balanced on you.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, but
when
you get the pack on, yeah. Yep.
Very cool.
Cool.
Awesome.
All right.
Thank you. Because this is Physics for Good, 50% of all the ad revenue generated from this episode will go to East Valley Firefighter Charities. So how can viewers support you besides just watching this video?
Well, we have a variety of ways. Again, we have our golf tournament coming up on December 1st. Hookandladdergolf.com is our website for the tournament.
Okay.
We also have the charity ride. It's always the Friday of Bike Week, Arizona Bike Week, so they can look to sign up for that. And then our website is www.firefightercharities.com, pretty easy to remember. And there's a donate button if anybody wants to donate that way.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for watching. If you like what you just saw, please consider subscribing right here and sharing the video with a friend. Also, check out the video description where you'll find a link to the charity you just saw, as well as some affiliate links.